Hello, welcome to City Hall this week. The Police Department's third quarter crime report is offering some encouraging news about crime overall in Durham. Chief Cerelyn Davis presented the report to the City Council during its November 21st meeting. The report shows that overall Part 1 index crime, which includes Part 1 property and violent crime, dropped by 7% during the first 9 months of 2016. That's compared to the same period in 2015. Part 1 violent crime, which includes homicide, rape, robbery, and aggravated assault, dropped slightly during the first three quarters of 2016. And Part 1 property crime, which includes burglary, larceny, and motor vehicle theft, dropped by 8% during the first 9 months of 2016. Again, that's compared to the same period last year. The full third quarter crime report can be found on the city's website. The police department is also getting 35 new vehicles as part of its take-home car program. The initiative is a three-year phased-in program to encourage officers to become more visible and invested in the Durham neighborhoods in which they live. Purchasing the 35 cars will cost $1.1 million. The city is looking at additional ways to get more residents involved in its budget process. Currently, a resident survey, coffees with council, public hearings, a citizen capital improvement panel, and strategic planning are used to gain feedback from the public on what it considers to be spending priorities for the upcoming year. At the request of the City Council, additional opportunities are being considered. These include developing a process in which residents can review existing plans to determine which projects to prioritize in the upcoming budget process. Establishing a Citizen Budget Advisory Committee to review and make recommendations on city departmental budgets and advise the City Council on the decision-making process. And expanding the role of the existing Citizen Capital Improvement Panel to include a review of city departmental budgets. The latest resident survey was conducted in November and results will be available in February. Did you know that much of what Durham residents and businesses throw out with their trash could actually be recycled or otherwise diverted from the landfill? A recent study of what's being thrown away in single-family, multifamily, and commercial waste shows that we can all be doing a much better job when it comes to reducing waste. Fiber products and containers that are currently accepted in the city's recycling program provide some of the biggest areas for improvement. While food waste, low-grade paper, and used clothing are also items that are being thrown out with the trash at a high rate. The city will be working to provide additional options for getting rid of organics, while also providing greater education to residents and businesses about what can and should be recycled. Big plans are in store for the Raleigh-Durham International Airport. The City Council received an update on those plans during its November 10th meeting by the members of the Airport Authority. The main item of focus is implementing the recently approved 2040 Master Plan. That plan includes a new rental facility between Terminals 1 and 2, a transportation facility for shuttles, limousines, and other such providers, moving and rebuilding the runway, and converting their current runway into a taxiway. RDU contributes $8.5 billion to the region's economy and serves more than 10 million passengers. That does it for City Hall this week. Don't forget to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter and Instagram. You can also find us on demand on Durham Television Network's webpage and on YouTube. Thank you for joining us.
This has been a production of Durham Television Network.